Hi, I'm Fernanda Oliveira.
Hello, I'm Kea Zasenas.
So for this week's reading response, we'll be going over key concepts as well as some questions we came up with.
So we will be talking about ADA and roofs.
Starting with ADA, that stands for Americans with Disability Act, we need to understand that disability access codes are civil rights. It is our duty as architects to support the independent living movement by, as said by Olivia, our guest speaker this week, one, understanding the code's intent, and then two, using accessibility as an opportunity for design. Since it is our goal to make accessible design just design, we must ensure the health, safety, and welfare of all. That being said, it is important to understand some code requirements. The first one I'll be talking about is cane protection. This refers to signalizing spaces in which the headroom is lower than 80 inches by adding a protection 27 inches or below. This is true because at 27 inches or below, a cane would be able to come in contact with this protection, warning the person of a dangerous zone in which they could potentially hit their heads or bump into objects that are protruding from the wall. Now, thinking about wheelchair accessibility, a few measurements to remember is that there must be a 32-inch clear path, and this includes in-between handles and door frames for a wheelchair to be able to exit and enter a building. It is also necessary to have clear spaces before and after the door to allow for this accessibility. And then when thinking about two wheelchairs together, they take a minimum of 66 inches, just thinking about quarter lengths and such. When talking about mobility and rotation of a wheelchair, there are two that are very common. The first one is the circle and the other one is a T-shape, in which the measurements are shown below. Now thinking about restrooms in ADA, here's a question. When designing ADA accessible restrooms, what is the diameter clearance required? As shown in this picture, it is a 60-inch minimum requirement. And then question number two, why are sinks required to be enclosed? And the answer is, these areas can burn the legs of someone who's lost their sensitivity. And there are minimum requirements as well as maximum height for these spaces of enclosure and countertop accessibility. The architectural example we found is the Ed Roberts campus by LMS Architects, and it follows the principles of universal design, which are the creation of environments that strive to be equally accessible and intuitive to the user for individuals of all abilities. And some characteristics I found really compelling are the use of the seven-foot-wide quarters. This goes back to the 66-inch minimum requirement for two wheelchair. This goes above and beyond that, taking this requirement as a point of start for creating accessible spaces. And then they also have oversized elevators with special controls for wheelchair riders. And then they also have high contrast interior finishes and colored and textured flooring.
Great. Now I'll be talking about roofing. First off, why is it important? It's the facade of the building on top of all the walls that a building has. And it's the first line of defense in a building against the weather since it's at the very top. It should really consist of well-developed arrangements as they are the building's front line. And some of the different types of roofing system include low slope roofs, steep roofs, cool roofs, green roofs, and photovoltaic roofs. Talk about low sloped roofs. These are also called flat roofs because flat roofs aren't actually flat. They have a slope. They have thermal insulation within these roofs that typically helps in stopping heat from coming in or out. Then an air barrier stops air leakage and the vapor retarder to prevent moisture, which can lead to other issues. And then on top of the roof membrane, the material must be chosen to protect the inner roof from water or other factors. And then for cool roofs, we have a technology that can prevent spaces from getting too hot. For example, the cool roof compared to a hot roof can deflect up to 80% of the heat coming from the sunlight, and it can reduce cooling energy costs for the building and can extend the lifespan of the roofing materials. Steep roofs, these are typically built with pitches that are very dramatic in angle, which really is determined by the style of the roof. So based on the slope, the rain and snow can run off easily and materials can be in small units. Thermal insulation and other procedures are similar to those of the sloped roofs. And weather, climate, and location, as well as building codes, can help make these roofs do their job properly. Next off, green roofs, as you can see from the picture in the background, are vegetated roofs that cover the roof membrane and protect it from harsh radiation. And they can really moderate temperature swings in the roof assembly since it's an extra layer of protection. The last one is photovoltaic systems. Again, these are photovoltaic materials that directly convert sunlight into energy. And yeah, typically PV power is fed into rechargeable batteries or some other type of storage system. Now, what are the different types of valleys? Because when we're putting together a roof, there's points where they can slope together and have this intersection where you have to intersect shingles. Three of them are open valley, woven valley, and close cut valley. You can see in the pictures what they really are about. This one uses a sheet of metal flashing at the corner. And then the last two are just like intertwining the shingles in a way that they overlap and don't allow water to seep in through the corner. And these two are the favorite two that contractors like the most. Now, there's a lot of challenges that comes with roofs. First off is that if a slow slope roof doesn't drain efficiently, ponding can occur as shown in this picture here, where water can just sit there for extended periods of time, like 2 hours. Time of roof drain operation, roof deck should be dry to avoid problems of water being trapped under the roof membrane. And lastly, the structure supporting a green roof must be designed to support the added weight of plant material. And that's it. We spent 4 hours on this project. Thank you.
Thank you.